वेलकम बैक टू माई चैनल. इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू अबाउट द डायरेक्शन ऑफ मैग्नेटिक फील्ड. सो इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द बायोट सावर्ट लॉ. सो यूजिंग दैट बायोट सावर्ट लॉ वी हैव कैलकुलेटेड हाउ मच अमाउंट ऑफ मैग्नेटिक फील्ड इज प्रेजेंट एट ए पर्टिकुलर पॉइंट. बट हेयर इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट इट्स डायरेक्शन, बिकॉज दिस मैग्नेटिक फील्ड इज अ वेक्टर क्वांटिटी. सो इफ इट इज अ वेक्टर क्वांटिटी मीन्स इट इज हैविंग सम पर्टिकुलर डायरेक्शन. सो वी विल स्टडी अबाउट इट्स डायरेक्शन, मीन्स हाउ टू डिटरमाइन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ magnetic field. So for example, here if this is a wire, if this is a wire, in this wire if I amount of current will be flowing and this is the point P, at this point P how much amount of magnetic field is present, that we know, but we don't know about the direction. So for that what we will do means we are having the two laws, that is we can use the screw rule also we can use, or else you can use the right hand palm rule. So using this right hand palm rule also we can determine the direction of magnetic field. So this method is very easy to determine magnetic field. So for that what we will do means we will take our right hand and we will place the thumb in the direction of the current, and the fingers will show the direction of the magnetic field. So here this is the direction of current, so I will place the thumb which is pointing in the direction of current and I will curl the fingers. When I am curling the fingers, if the fingers are going inward, means if these fingers are curling inward, then we can say that magnetic field is inward at this point P. Suppose if you take the point Q here and again I will place the thumb in direction of current, and if I curl the fingers, then this at this point Q the fingers are pointing outward. So if the fingers are pointing outward, means we can say that magnetic field is outward at this point Q, and at this point Q the magnetic field is inward because the fingers are curling inward. So at this point the fingers are curling outward. So here the inward magnetic field can be represented by the cross and the outward magnetic field is represented by the dot. So here I will write inward magnetic field is represented by the cross and outward is represented by the dot. Why we are representing like this means you see this arrow. This is the arrow, this is the front of the arrow and this is the back of the arrow. Suppose if this arrow is coming towards you, if this arrow is coming towards you means what we can observe, we can observe the front portion of the arrow and the front portion will appears to be a tip. So if the same arrow is going inwards, means if it is going inward the bore, then what we can see means we can see the back portion of the arrow. So if we are observing the back portion, then we can represent it by the cross. If it is coming outward, then we can represent it as a dot. So because by this arrow you can understand why we are representing cross and dot for the inward and outward magnetic field. So now I will give you one example, by that you can easily understand. So this is our first example. This is our wire. In this wire I amount of current is flowing and this is the point P. And next I will take second example. This is the wire. In this wire current is going downward and this is the point Q. And next after that this is the direction of the current in the third example, and in fourth example this is the direction of the current I. Here this is the point P and here this is the point Q. So now we will try to find out the direction of the magnetic field. So now here the current is flowing in this direction, means again we will take our right hand and we will place the thumb in the direction of the current, means in which direction current is flowing, we'll place like this, and again we will curl the fingers. So when you are curling the fingers at this point P, our fingers are curling inward. So here the magnetic field is inward. So inward magnetic field is represented by the cross. So here the magnetic field is inward. So next after that you see this example. So in this example the current is going in this direction, so we will place our thumb in the direction of the current and again we will curl the fingers. So when you are curling the fingers at this point Q, the fingers are coming outward, so the outward magnetic field can be represented by the dot. So this is the direction of magnetic field, means at this point Q the direction of magnetic field is dot. Dot means outward magnetic field. So next after that third example. In this third example magnetic field means the current is going inward, the current is going inward. If the current is going inward, means we will take this thumb and we will place in the direction of the current and we will curl the fingers. So when you are curling the fingers, so this is the direction of the magnetic field. And next, how the magnetic field is produced, means the magnetic field is produced like this in the clockwise direction. So this is the direction of the current. So the direction of the magnetic field, will take it as the clockwise magnetic field. I will write here clockwise magnetic field. If the current is inward, so see the fingers, are curling in the clockwise direction. So clockwise direction means this is the direction of the magnetic field at this point P. Always it is making 90 degree. And next, after that, see here, in this case current is outward, the current is pointing outward. So this thumb we will take like this in the direction of current, and again we will curl the fingers. So when you are curling the fingers, these fingers are curling in the anti-clockwise direction. So this is the direction of the magnetic field. And if you take magnetic field, then it is in the anti-clockwise direction. So here I will write anti-clockwise magnetic field. So this is how we will determine the direction of the magnetic field using our right hand palm rule. But if you use left hand, then what happens, means all the answers you will get in the negative form, means you will get the reverse. So always you have to use the right hand and it will give you the correct result. And you have to place this thumb in the direction of current and all these fingers where they will curl, it will show the direction of the magnetic field. Only these two things you have to remember to determine the direction of the magnetic field. And another thing, DB is always perpendicular to DL and DB is always perpendicular to DR. These two concepts, these two things you have to remember for the mathematical calculation. This thing we can go for direction of the magnetic field, but for calculation, for mathematical calculation, these two things you have to always remember. So this is all about the finding the direction of magnetic field. So in next class we will study about the applications of the Biot-Savart law. Application means we will take one straight wire, because of that straight wire how much amount of magnetic field will be produced. All those things we will study in the next class. So stay tuned.